What up? It's your boy Joe Easy. Welcome to another edition of Joe Easy Delivers. Welcome back, my new viewers. Welcome to the channel. Okay, today is Friday, baby. It's Friday, then. It's Saturday, Sunday, yeah. Friday. January 19th. And guys, okay, I haven't been able to make $200, guys. So I noticed that I get mad on days that otherwise would have been a good day. Like when I made $170, I was kind of mad that I didn't make the 200. And when I made 150, I was kind of mad that I didn't make the 200. And I'm like, bro, these days would have otherwise been great days. 150, 170, those are win days for me, man. So, and I am becoming a little bit ungrateful by, you know, not being grateful, be ungrateful by getting mad at, you know, of these days. So you know what? Look, the goal is still gonna be $200, but we're gonna do it so that we're gonna switch it up so that when we don't make $200, it won't be the end of the world. This is the schedule that I'm gonna try out to increase my chances of getting $200 throughout the day. So it's gonna be my schedule from 12 to 5. And then it says 12 to 5, but I'm gonna maybe do 12 to 6 to have at least 6 hours of sleep, because 5 hours is not gonna be enough, guys. Because they go to the gym and, you know, moving around. I need at least, honestly, I need 7 hours, but I'm gonna see if I can go with 6 hours of sleep. 12 to 6, sleep. 6 to 7, wake up, get ready, and go to Publix. For the Publix drop at 7 o'clock. 7 to 2, work. So that's 7 hours right there I'm working. From 2 to 6, go to the gym, have my lunch, edit my videos, and then from 6 to 10, work again, and then from 10 to 12, go home, go to sleep, get ready to sleep, go on my phone or whatever, and then sleep. So from 12 to 6, or I have 12 to 5, but I think I'm gonna do 12 to 6, and that's gonna be the schedule. So 7 to 2 is gonna be working 7 hours, and then 6 to 10, 4 hours, so that's gonna be 11 hours of work time that I'm gonna try to get the most amount of money. We will see what happens, guys. And the 6 hours of sleep, I don't know how sustainable that's gonna be, because I might need a little bit more sleep, but I'm gonna try to push my body to where I don't have to, you know, sleep so many hours. And to be able to get the body like that, you have to eat healthy. And when you do sleep, have REM sleep, which is deep sleep. You have to have very good sleep so that you don't have to be sleeping anymore. Dieting, you know, eating the right foods, stuff like that. And then staying, you know, active and stuff like that, so that, you know, like you don't need to be sleeping so much and you don't feel tired all the time and you have energy. This is gonna be the strategy for the time being. We will see what happens, guys. And we actually got a delivered order for $27. So that's gonna set us up very good for today, guys. So it could be a little bit more possible with the $27 secured earnings in delivered. It's gonna be delivered. I have to pick it up like at 10:20 in the morning. So we will see what happens. Now, with that being said, let's not waste any more time on this intro, all right? Don't forget to smash that like button, bro, for the YouTube world. And if you like this video, at the end, you want to finish with this and me doing deliveries to a couple of my people. Let's get the hustle started. Let's go. My lovely humans, the time is, what time is it? 7:54 in the morning, and we accepted our first order of the day. Oh, I forgot my wallet. Hold on. All right, we got the wallet. We accepted a $17.96 order, so let's say $18 for 7 items. 7 items, Lowe's, as you can see here, Lowe's. And they're all small items, nothing big, nothing crazy. Let's go get it. Ah, shelf. Okay, I thought it was shelf 6. No, shelf 16 for our first item is some tape. So right here, the original tape. So this is it, 1.88 inch. Let me just start scanning. No, I need a bigger one, I think maybe. Let me check if it's this one right here. No. Okay, let me read what I need. Okay, so it's 1.41, but the customer asked for 1.88. I think it's the width of the thing. Oh, this is supposed to be it right here. Oh, I know why. Okay, we got it, guys. There was the wrong one stuck on the bright box. So I was looking in the right place. It's just that one. Okay, we got it though. 3 of these. Oh, I'm on Uber Eats. I gotta clock out. The second item is here as well, in the same aisle and shelf. I believe it's this. Let me scan it just to, yep. This other tape that we need. We also need a wood filler. This is a pretty nice order. Maybe I should start doing Lowe's orders. Do like a video only doing Lowe's orders. So this is the other one. I think this is the next item. I don't even know what this is. Let's just scan it.
No, Blue Hawk. I do need Blue Hawk. It's just I need a different Blue Hawk.
1216,
and this was 1620. I need 1216. 1620. It's 1216. It's just a different brand. What is this anyway? Reversible tarp. So it's a tarp. So it should be this 1216. Because it's the same price. Oh, this is it right here. Look. This is just a different brand, but it's scanned, but good. Two of these. So the next item is some sealant. Check this out, guys. You guys remember the commercial? The flex shot that the guy is trying to sell this? I need amp, but the blue amp. There's a green amp. This is what I need. You guys see it here? Look. This is what I need. Damp amp. Oh, I see it right here. Yep, we got it, guys. Four of these. So with Lowe's, if I don't know what something is, I look at the price, because normally the price, it seems like the price is the same on the Instacart app than here. It's like the same price. I don't know how Instacart makes money off of this. Maybe they charge a high delivery fee. I don't know. But look, $18.98. This says $18.98. Let's just scan it to make sure. And this is it. You see? So the last item is these moving boxes. And then we are done. This is it. Let's go. So it's been 12 minutes and we are done. Everything was in stock. 1,000,000,000% right here. Let's go pay for this and deliver. Let's do it, babe. So the time is 8:46 and we accepted an order right after we delivered this one. It's a $10 order for 3 items. Instacart, but it is, and I have to drive maybe like a mile away. Ooh, it's like a mile from here. Walgreens, Instacart. It's a 6-mile order, 2 customers. $10, it sounds like a trash order. But I was talking to you guys on my live, whoever joined my live, asking the question. And I was serious. Like, I was thinking about this. Like, if you multi-apping, are we hurting ourselves by losing the momentum in whatever batch or whatever app we're using? Like, I got as soon as I delivered this order, I saw a $30 order for Aldi. 3 customers, 60 items. And then I saw this one, $10. I'd rather do this one now. I'm not even gonna lie. $10 for 6 miles, 3 items. That's it, 2 customers. So it's in and out of the store. Those are the orders I like. In and out of the store. I don't care about the driving and I don't care about the heavy lifting. As long as it's not 60 items. So I do those. So I accepted it quick, you know, to see if maybe, you know, it helps. You know, Instacart continued to feed me orders. As soon as I completed an order, I accept another order right away. I don't know. But we're also trying to make money, continue to make money. But also, I want to make as much money as possible before the delivered order, $30 order. So once I do this, I just did a set $18 order plus $10. So it's $28 plus a $30 order. I'm going to be at $60 before 11 o'clock. That's going to be good. So it's gonna be a higher chance that we make the 200, and that this strategy or this schedule of working 12 to 5, or no, yeah, 7, the Publix drop, 7 to 2 working, and then 2 to 6 do my gym delivery, I mean gym editing videos, all that stuff, and then 6 to 10 deliveries, something, you know? So I don't know, we'll see. But hey, so far it's been good, guys. It's a good start. The $17. We're gonna do a $10. We're gonna do the delivered, and then let's go, baby. Let's do it. So I'm parking a little bit far away from the Walgreens because, you know, whoever decided to do this, they have this thing here, so I can't make a left. You know, like, and if you're there, you can't make a left. Even though they have the street there, I'm gonna show you right now. They have the street where you could make a left, but they blocked it. I don't know. Maybe there's been a lot of car crashes. Who knows? But I had to park all the way back there. All the way back there. And then I'm now gonna walk. It's not that far away anyway. So look, this guy can't make a left, that van. You see? There's a street right there where you could make a left, but you really can't because they have it blocked. But it's alright, look, the Walgreens is right here anyway, so it's not that much walking. So let's go get it. And look, runner's high. When I don't know if you guys knew, but I used to run track and field and cross country, and I went to states in the mile. I got 10th place in states. So that's actually really good. But this is it right here. All right, let's go to Walgreens, guys. We're here. The first item is some wipes, but I don't know if this is it. Oh no, this is the one. This is a 16 count. So this is for customer A. We need this right here for customer B. This is the only customer B item, a trash bag. The last item is this vitamin B1 for customer A, and then we are done. Okay, so it's been 1.5 minutes and we are done. So this is customer A right here. Customer B is just a trash bag, and that is it. Let's go pay for this and deliver. Let's do it. All right, my people, we are here at Lime Fresh, and it's a big order, guys. So I'm gonna take it one by one, and I'll show you guys in the end what it is. But right now, it's a bunch of chips and chips and stuff like that. So I'll get with you guys when I'm done with it. So we got everything. This is a big order, pretty big order. So we got a lot of stuff here. We got rice, beans, and all that stuff. We got the shells right here. A bag of, I think that's the utensils. The other bag is over there. Let me show you. This is the other bag. I think this is protein. This is the chips and the other stuff. And that is it, guys. Let's go deliver it. Let's do it. We got our handy dandy wagon that we're gonna use again. And I'm gonna carry the other one with my bag here. And I put the link, I had taken out the link to the Amazon for this wagon. I had taken it out, but I'm gonna put it back in case you guys wanna, buy. There's some cheaper ones out there, but I mean, if you click on it, you'll see like recommendations if you wanna buy something cheaper. And there's actually a more expensive Ozark Trail one there too. But let's go get it. It's to this first floor, but I still have to take this wagon. Let's go. It's to an office. The kitchen. But we're done with that order. I spread it out, I put it there and took the picture nice, as nice as possible. I think I got an email the other day about with from Deliver saying, hey, one of the customers said that you didn't spread it out properly or something like that. I'm like, bro, what are you talking about? I don't know, man. I didn't have to spread it out because nothing was in bags anyway, but I spread it out as much as I can so the next customer doesn't get mad, you know? But yeah, let's continue. The time is, what time is it? 11, right? Yeah, 11:03, we accepted a $6 order. $6 and change for 3.6 miles right here. This is the name of the place, the butcher shop. So we're just trying to wait till we make a left right here, and it is right there. Let's get it.
This is para my year.
Gracias. All right, the order was nice and ready. Let's deliver, let's do it. Okay, the time is 12:09 p.m. and we accepted a roti order. So now I'm gonna get on the roti grind again. It's a prescription roti, CVS. If you guys didn't know about that, roti is owned by UPS. So they do Home Depot, they do Walmart. I just have to go to a Walmart. I should do a video one day and actually go to a Walmart and see if like I could do like a roti pickup roti. I just see how it is. I don't know. I'm not on Spark, guys. But it's gonna be a prescription pickup, $8, 3 miles. Let's go.
So pretty much you just have to go to the pharmacy and pick up, I guess. Tom, well, I'm from roti or whatever. Hello.
How you doing?
Good, good. I gotta pick up a roti order. All right, appreciate it.
Thank you very much.
All right, we got it, guys. We just gotta take a picture of it. I think they make you take a picture. I'm gonna have to cut that off so I don't show the customer's info. And then that's it. Oh, they didn't have the scanning before. Look, check it out. They have the scanning now. They didn't have that before. Before you just had to take a picture, but I like the scanning features a little bit more safe. All right, let's deliver, guys.
Well, the app process improved drastically when dropping off these prescriptions, because before it was very confusing. And I think they saw my video of me, you know, complaining about it. Like, it said, you have to take a picture of it, but then you had to like give it to the customer. So instead of leaving it at the door, you take a picture and then you give it to the customer. And then it's like, what if you forget to take a picture? And then it, like, the steps were a little bit weird, but this time it's like, all right, leave it at the door and then put exactly like where you left it. And it's like, oh, is the item visible of where you left it? And I said, yes. Is it clearly show where you have it? Yes. And this and that, and then you complete it, and then that's it. And I know a lot of people are probably gonna say, Joe Easy, you're not supposed to leave prescriptions at the door. Well, in Florida you could do it, guys. That's what it told me to do. It said leave it at the door. With shipped, it said that you had to Like, it was kind of weird with ship. Like, it said that you had to give it to him, but I don't know. But this one said to leave it, so I left it. All right, and let's continue. Oh, I forgot to give you the backstory about the ship. The reason why I mentioned ship, because prescriptions, like the CVS used to work with ship to pick up the orders. So you pick it up and you drop it off. Well, they ship stopped using prescriptions. They stopped doing prescription orders. And I used to do, I don't know, for my OGs, you guys already know that I used to do a lot of ship prescriptions. And then they stopped doing it. So now Rody is using CVS. I think their contract ended and they didn't want to renew it. So now they're using Rody now. Rody, which is owned by UPS. So I guess if you guys want to download the app and check it out, if it's in your area, they have Home Depot, CVS prescriptions. They have other things too. I think there's flower delivery as well. But the most, and then they have Walmart. I haven't done Walmart yet. But the biggest thing that I've seen is Home Depot. So if you guys want to check it out. My lovely humans, the time is 12:39 p.m. and we accepted what did we accept? A $14 Uber Eats order for 3.8 miles, but it's two customers. So this is the first place called Cuban Guys. The other place, I don't know what it is, but let's go get it. $14. So it has been a really good start to the day. That's amazing. I love it. And you know what, guys? I'm gonna stop, like, if I, because last time I got $150 and I was like, oh, I didn't get $200. And it's like, bro, $150, we used to jump and joy for that, or I used to jump and joy for that. And now I was like, I'm like not being grateful enough for the $200. I mean, for like the $150. So I'm gonna stop being ungrateful that I make like good money, man. You know what I'm saying? And we can make that, so, you know, as many times as possible, we'll be good, guys. But yeah, I'm gonna stop being ungrateful for good days like that. $150. So let's go get it. Pick up for lunch. All right, my people, we got the order. It was it's 12 burgers, so the order could be more than $14. I don't know. We'll see. The other place is called Sushi Maki. Let's do it. Headed to our second destination here at Sushi Maki. Nothing on the show right here, I guess. Thank you. All right, we got the order, guys. Let's go start our delivery journey. Let's do it. Gracias. Okay, so I'm not going to do this order, the DoorDash. I was able to clock on DoorDash. And I was able to get a schedule for the whole week. With the new schedule that I told you guys in the beginning of the video, I did a schedule, like, throughout the whole week, you know, with that 2 to 6 break that I'm going to have. But I'm not going to accept this order, $4.50 for 3.2 miles, because I want the minimum to be at least 5. I want to be making 5, because these orders take, sometimes they could take 15 minutes. So, if $4.50, I'm not going to do it, the minimum 5. But I would have done it if it was an extra 50 cents. I know it's 50 cents, but it's just, you know, you want to have a minimum either. You don't want to be doing, like, stuff like, you know, because you start taking everything, and then, you know, with this new schedule, if I'm working 7 to 2 and then 6 to 10, throughout all those hours, I should be getting some pretty decent orders. Now, the question is, that's 11 hours working, but it's fine because this I like the schedule, because now, like, on slow days, Wednesday, Thursday, I'm going to be able to follow the same schedule. Wake up at 5 or 6 in the morning. If I don't work, use, you know, instead of the 7 to 2 to work, instead of working, you know, doing deliveries, I can work on my Giga app. So even if it's like a day off, work on the Giga app from 7 to 2, 2 to 6, have my lunch, edit videos, go to the gym, and then 6 to 10, maybe I could do delivery. So half a day. I could do Wednesday, instead of, on the slow days, Wednesday, Thursday, instead of taking the whole day off, I only work 6. Oh, look. So it's another, I forgot a screenshot. I went down to 39% acceptance rating on DoorDash, but I'm going to respectfully decline the $3.75 for 5.1 miles. Respectfully decline. Let's go. All right, ladies and gentlemen, if you made it to the end of this video, thank you for watching. All right, this is how much you made for the day. On Instacart, we made $61.42. On Uber Eats, we made $50.58. On DoorDash, you made $27.25 in one shift, right? Yeah, in one shift. And then on Delivered, we made $27.50. And on Rody, we did Rody, remember, $8.45 for a total of $175.50. It is not 200, but I'm happy. I'm done not being happy about these days. I'm happy with the $175. Hopefully we can continue the momentum with the same strategy. 7 to 2, 6 to 11, plus or minus like a few hours. Plus or minus maybe an hour each time, because maybe one day I oversleep and I start at 7:30 instead of 7, or like maybe, like right now, it's the next day. It's 1 o'clock right now, the next day. It's been a good morning so far, but it's 1 o'clock and I'm thinking, you know what, man? I've been here for half an hour not taking any orders. I might as well just call it and then just go to the gym already. You know, even though the schedule does say 2, maybe just call it slow anyway. I'm gonna finish editing this video right here. So it's like, once I'm done, might as well just go to the gym, and then maybe, you know, from 1:30 instead of 2, 1:30 to maybe 6:30. Sometimes, that's another thing. It may not be 6, I might start earlier too. Like on this shift that you saw, I didn't start at 6. I started like a little bit earlier, like at 4:30, 5 o'clock. But the whole main idea is to be able to get the morning orders, and then it dies out between 10 and 12. Once you guys, you guys already know this. Between 10 and 12, it dies out. But you get a good amount of morning orders. You do that. And then lunchtime. If you have a dead lunch, like on this shift, I didn't have such a good lunch. And then in the next video that you're going to see, I'm not having such a good lunch. You know, you have a dead lunch, whatever. And then you go do your thing. Edit videos, you know, go to the gym. But in your case, if you guys want to try out the strategy, in your case, it could be something else. Go home to your kids or whatever. And you know, I don't know what it is. Do that, and then you come back out when it's busy again, like at 6 o'clock or plus or minus, like dinner shift. And then you get the best of both worlds. You get the busyness of the morning time, the busyness maybe of the lunchtime, depending on the day. Sometimes the lunch is super slow, super dead. There's nothing going on. Like in the next video, you'll see nothing's really going on, so I might just stop. And then dinner shift, you get the best of the dinner shift, and hopefully you make $200. Hopefully. If you get the peak times of the day, hopefully you get to $200 as many days as possible. We will see what happens, but it was great. 175. The orders that we did off camera, I apologize. We did a $6.50 order, 3 miles, 17 minutes to complete, Uber Eats. $7.24 order, 3.1 miles, 40 minutes to complete. A $7.02 order, 3.2 miles, 17 minutes to complete. A $9.32 order, 3 miles, 16 minutes to complete. And then Instacart, we did 3 Instacart orders off camera. $14.64, $5.34 base pay, $9.30 tip. An $11 flat order, $5.43 order. A base pay, $5.57 tip, and then a $7.56 order, $5.36 base pay, $2.20 tip. Oh, I didn't show you guys. Look, the $7.24 order, it was $12.24, and then they removed the whole tip. They removed it. So, bro, man. And you know what else happened too? I got a contract violation for DoorDash. Let me show you the order that it happened in. I'm thinking the Uber Eats order, it was Uber Eats, a fresh market order, Uber Eats. And I'm thinking, what could it be? What could it have been? I gave them the tuna. I gave them 2 free croissants, 2 packs of croissants, because it's supposed to be free. I should have never given it to them because, well, whatever. You're thinking this thing, so bro, you look, sometimes you feel like you want to go to that person's house. Like you stuff that you see on online of people going to other people's house. Oh, you didn't tip or you removed the tip. And in your head, you're like, you want to do it, but it's like, nah, bro, let me not be that person, you know? But you kind of want to do it. It's like, they took it away. And I'm thinking, bro, what could it have been? Could it have been, like, I don't know. Maybe the peanuts. It was honey roasted peanuts. I substituted the peanuts. It was a different brand of the peanuts. So maybe they got mad about the peanuts. I don't know, but that's actually the only thing. The peanuts. That's the only thing I could think of. The peanuts that didn't like it, so they removed the tip. But it would have been even worse because they asked for a PIN. So it could have been a customer that always does the same thing. They always do it. And then they asked for the PIN. If it wasn't for the PIN, maybe they would have marked it as never arrived. And so they had the PIN, so they were unable to do the never arrived. So they just removed the tip, I guess, just to spite me. And then I got a contract violation right here on DoorDash. And it was a Levi's door. The picture, it was a Levi's door, and then it has the picture of like the previous successful delivery. And then I took a picture of it, and then I put on the reason. Because I disputed the contract violation. I said, oh, if you look at the previous photo, previous successfully delivered, it shows the exact same door. And then I went to the to the same exact door. If you compare the last picture that was successfully delivered, and then this picture, it's the same exact entrance, the same exact door. So it's not that it was never delivered. I think I know why the customer got mad though. I'll tell you now. But these are the orders that we did off camera. Oh, look, here we go. This is the order right here. $9 order, 3.8 miles. We ended it. And it ended up being a $9 order, $5 tip, $4 base pay. Look, I understand the customer getting mad. It was for some dates. If you guys don't know, it looks like old grapes. Some dates. They wanted 1.75 pounds. They only had 0.75 pounds. Maybe my mistake was I should have told the customer, hey, they only have this. Do you want it? And then if not, I told them, tell them to cancel. Maybe next time I'm going to tell them to cancel. But I didn't do that. I just put, instead of 1.75, I put 0.75. And then I delivered it. And then the tip stays the same. It's not a variable tip. $5. So the customer probably got mad. Bro, I only got 0.75 pounds instead of 1.75, 0.75. And then I gave that kid a $5 tip. You know what? I'm going to mark never delivered, and boom, I get a contract violation. So I understand the customer getting mad, but it's like, at least put that, I don't know, don't put that it wasn't delivered, put something else. But I disputed it, and then I told DoorDash, I was like, yo, if you go back to the last picture that was successfully completed, you're gonna see that I did deliver it. So I mean, at least give me a one star. A one star is better than a contract violation, you know. But whatever. So I disputed it. I'll let you guys know in a future video if it gets taken off. Oh, I'm gonna show you. Oh, I'm gonna show you guys later, like what it looks like, the contract violation. The first time I get one. And then we did a $7.50 Walgreens order, 2.3 miles for one item. We completed it, and it ended up being a $7.50 order, $4.50 base pay. I mean tip, $3 base pay, and then a $5 order. DoorDash, 1.9 miles, we completed it. Ended up being a $3 tip with a $2 base pay. And then we did this order. I had declined it, and then I accepted it the second time. $5.75. At first it was $5.25, then ended up being $5.75, 2.2 miles. I completed it, ended up being a $3 base pay, $3 tip, $2.75 base pay. And that is it, guys. Look, let me show you guys the contract violation right here. Look, one contract violation. You click on it and it says, this delivery was marked as completed in the Dasher app, but the customer reported it as never arrived. And then it's, you see on there on top, contactless, the fresh market yesterday, 1/19/2024. Tip for contactless deliveries, blah blah, submit photo, check all that baloney. So we'll see if they take it off. Hopefully they take it off. If they don't, whatever, man, it is what it is. It's the first time I get a contract violation in my life. How many deliveries do I have? I have a lot of deliveries. I have 1,702 lifetime deliveries on DoorDash. But it's all right, guys. If you made it to the end of this journey, though, my lovely hoopy, thank you for watching. Don't forget to smash that like button to help me blow up in the YouTube world. And if you like the video and you want to watch future videos, meet the deliveries you got with my people. Oh, just so you guys know, the tip that was removed on Uber Eats and the DoorDash contract violation, they were both fresh market orders. And I'm thinking about not doing fresh market orders ever again, because fresh market has never been a good experience. It's always been a bad experience. They never have whatever the customer wants. They never have, like, it's like, isn't that, I mean, a lot of times it is good, but a lot of times it's bad. So I might just exit that order. I don't know. We'll see what happens. I mean, if it's a banger order, I have to do it. But whatever. Okay, love yourself, believe yourself. It's your boy Choice. Let's go.